Joining us this morning, Fred Kagan, Director of Critical Threats Project at the American Enterprise Institute. Fred is also the co-author of this new article, A Strategy to Defeat the Islamic State. In addition to Fred Kagan, we are also joined by Fred Fleitz, the chief analyst at Lignet. Gentlemen, we thank you both for Skyping in this morning to America's Forum. Fred Fleitz, let's start with you. What is the latest you're hearing in terms of intelligence in this air war?
Well, now that we've had several days of airstrikes, JD, there's an assessment on what's being accomplished. And I'm hearing from people like a former CIA director, Michael Hayden, who discussed this with Newsmax yesterday, and other experts, that we really need better intelligence to find better targets. Hayden thinks we're hitting easy targets. Colonel Ralph Peters is saying that we're hitting targets at night when buildings are not occupied. I've been concerned that the president telegraphed to ISIS that attacks were coming and they may have evacuated some of these buildings. And so I agree with former CIA Director Hayden that we need to get better intelligence on the ground to hit the best targets. Now, hitting these oil facilities was very important. I think you know that Newsmax President Christopher Ruddy has long called for an attack on the oil facilities to cut off ISIS's finances. I think this is a good move to starving this organization of resources.
Speaking of Mike Hayden, Fred Fleitz, it's worth noting that the general will join us following the break. Now let's turn to Fred Kagan. Fred, you've written this article, The Strategy for Defeating the Islamic State. We understand there is some dissension in the coalition. The Syrian rebels we're now training and arming say they're against the airstrikes because they think this tips the balance of power toward the Assad regime in Syria. Is that a legitimate concern?
Well, it is a legitimate concern, but I think it's also important to understand that you have a bunch of different pressures on some of those Syrian groups, including from Jabhat al-Nusra, which is heavily intertwined with a lot of the opposition groups that we would otherwise like to be helping. So when I hear statements like that coming out of the Syrian opposition, one of my questions is, where are those statements actually originating? And this gets to the point that you really can't have that conversation from 30,000 feet via JDAM. And it's really kind of a problem to be doing this without actually having human beings on the ground who can talk to the human beings on the ground who really matter.
Fred Fleitz, it was widely reported that the squadron commander of the UAE flying an F-16 was a woman, Major Miriam Al-Mansouri. Is there a psychological advantage to this for the coalition?
I see two important takeaways to this. I think it is an important psychological message to ISIS. ISIS's fanatical view, central to this, is a medieval view, which involves the oppression and exploitation of women. Here we have a woman bombing ISIS in an F-16 jet. But on another level, this sends a message to the entire Middle East that women have rights, women should be allowed to drive, which is a big issue in Saudi Arabia, and I think it helps counter this radical Sharia ideology. It's a small step in that direction, but I think an important one.
Now, about the at the United Nations, let's take a listen.
Today, the people of the world have been horrified by another brutal murder of Hervé Goudel by terrorists in Algeria. President Hollon, we stand with you and the French people, not only as you grieve this terrible loss, but as you show resolve against terror and in defense of liberty.
Fred Kagan, let me go to you. This beheading, widely regarded as revenge for the French airstrikes earlier, what do we know about this group, Jund al-Khalifa?
The specific group, I'm not personally exactly tracking what that is. In general terms, we have a significant presence of al-Qaeda affiliates circling around al-Qaeda and the Islamic Maghreb in that area, which has grown significantly in its strength and its influence and its ability to operate. And this is something for which we have no strategy whatsoever, but it's very, very concerning. People were very excited when the French went in to Mali, and the problem is that they made the same mistakes in Mali that we made in Afghanistan in 2002, pulling out too quickly, not concerning themselves enough with establishing any kind of stable order. And so one of the results of that intervention was to scatter a lot of Al-Qaeda-affiliated groups throughout the Sahel, throughout Northern Africa, and help metastasize this problem even more. So this is something we really need to look at and be concerned about as well, when not get too fixated on ISIS as being the only Al-Qaeda problem that we have.
Fred Fleitz, we just heard Fred Kagan kind of give us the genesis of these different ISIS or Al-Qaeda-linked groups. What do you think about the beheading in Algeria of the French citizen? Was this something that was coordinated, or do you think this falls in the realm of copycat terror groups, Fred Fleitz?
I think it shows that there is a broad radical Islamist movement and that they support each other's goals. We don't know whether this was actually an ISIS a group in Algeria, or whether it was directly linked or not, but we've seen this kind of thing happen before. We know that Al-Shabaab in Somalia has executed a French hostage. It kicked off violence in Algeria. I think we're going to see similar actions like this, because although these groups have some internal differences, they are at war with the West, and I think they support that as their primary goal.
Gentlemen, about 3 minutes remain. Fred Kagan, back to you. We just highlighted your article. Could you give us a brief overview of the way you believe ISIS can be defeated?
Yes, and thanks for that, by the way. Look, we need to recognize that the problem is within the Sunni Arab community within Iraq and Syria. And the solution also has to come from the Sunni Arab community within Iraq and Syria. We have worked with Sunni Arabs in Iraq before to fight against Al-Qaeda in Iraq, this group's predecessor. We need to find out whether those tribes or other tribes there, and whether Sunni Arabs in Syria are willing and able to stand with us. We're not going to be able to find that out from 30,000 feet. We need to send special forces into the Sunni Arab lands in Iraq and Syria as quickly as possible to make contact with the people who could have a decisive effect on this effort, and see whether there is a strategy there that could be successful. That's got to be the priority.
And that differs with what we're hearing from our commander-in-chief, as he again talks about, quote, no boots on the ground. Fred Kagan, you're making the case for special forces in selected circumstances. Now, gentlemen, back here in the homeland, New York and New Jersey are on high alert, with both governors reminding residents of their respective states to stay vigilant.
I want the people of the region to know that, from my perspective, this is something that's absolutely necessary for us to do. In light of the new and increased tensions that we know are going on around the world. We have seen before that you ignore these increased tensions at the peril of the people you serve. And Governor Cuomo and I have made the decision that we will not ignore those increased tensions, even without a specific threat being in place.
It's also undeniable, but that this region is a potential target for offensive activities, retaliation, by the terrorist community. We know that. As elected officials, as Governor Christie said, public safety is job one, and our job is to make sure we're doing everything we can do to be prepared.
Fred Fleitz, about 15 seconds left. That sounds like post 9/11, echoes of what happened back over a decade ago, doesn't it?
It's exactly right. Obama officials are trying to say there's no evidence ISIS wants to attack the U.S. They just tried to stage beheadings, JD, in Australia. I think we have to assume they're coming here, especially after the airstrikes.
Fred Fleitz of Lignet and Fred Kagan of AEI, gentlemen, to you both, we thank you very much for your insights and analysis as the air war continues. And we'll see if, as Fred Kagan advocates, we see special forces working with the Sunni Muslims. Coming up, General Mike Hayden, his assessment of where the air war is, that's next on America's Forum.